Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly create a powerful luminous text effect. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl N on Windows or Command N on a Mac. Make the width 1550 pixels, the height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white, click this icon or press D on your keyboard. To fill your document with black, press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it with the foreground color. We want to invert them. To do this, click this icon or press X on your keyboard. Open your Horizontal Type tool and pick a font. I'm using MT Mattoscript Bold. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in the video description or project files. Choose a size that will fit all of your words comfortably on your document. The anti-aliasing is irrelevant since we're ultimately going to blur the font. The color should be white. Click on your document and type out your text. If you have more than one line of text and want to adjust the space between lines, also known as leading, go to Window and Character. This opens the Character panel. Double-click the large T to highlight all the lines of text and slide the leading icon to the right or left to shift the leading down or up. When you're done, you can close the Character panel. To reposition it on your document, open your Move tool and move it. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. When you see this warning, click OK to rasterize the text. I'll blur it 6 pixels, however, if the size of your text is larger, you should increase the amount of blur until it looks similar to this example. Then, click OK. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and choose Levels. Make the black input 156, the mid-tone input 0.64, and keep the white input 255. Click the adjustment layer again, and this time choose color balance. For shadows, make the cyan red 41 and the yellow blue minus 65. For mid-tones, make the cyan red 5, the magenta green 50, and the yellow blue minus 100. For highlights, make the cyan red 100, and the other colors minus 100. If your text has areas that are a bit too thin and hard to see, click the thumbnail of the text layer to make it active, and hold down Ctrl or Command as you click on it again to make a selection of its shape. Hide the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Open your brush tool and give it a medium size. The hardness is 0% and reduce its opacity to 10%. Now, brush over areas that you want to make more visible. To deselect the hidden selection, press Ctrl or Command D. Make a composite snapshot of your image by making your top layer active and pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Select and Color Range. Select Shadows and click OK to make a selection. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut the text from its background and copy it to its own layer. Since we now have the text cut from the composite snapshot, we don't need the composite snapshot anymore. Let's drag it to the trash. Double-click the thumbnail of the cutout text to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow. Click the color box and pick bright red. Its numeric value is FF and 4 zeros. Then click OK. Change the blend mode to normal. The opacity is 75% and the spread is 10%. I'll make the glow size 38 pixels. However, if your text is larger, make the glow size larger as well. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.